Hi everybody, Jewel here for J7409 Weather with your tropical update today, Wednesday, October the 14th, 2020. Of course, we can see here is disturbance number one. We're going to get to it. I'm going to show you everything with it. But we may. Now, I said we may. I do not have a crystal ball. A lot of things can change with these systems, as you guys know. They change from hour to hour. But right now, it's looking like there could be one to make up right around here and move this way and then up this way. We'll have to keep our eyes on it. Then, coming up maybe the end of next weekend, about a week from now, we're going to have another one that's going to move off of here. This is what it looks like. I'll show you. And then it's going to come up this way. We're going to have to wait and see what happens with that. But let's take them one by one. This one is on the National Hurricane Center chart right now. Disturbance number one. These other two, they're not, but they could make up. I'm telling you now so you'll be aware. So let's get with it. Now, disturbance number one, it's a broad area of low pressure. It's located a few hundred miles east of the Lesser Antilles, and it continues to produce a large area of disorganized showers and thunderstorms, mainly to the east of its center. Now, strong upper-level winds are expected to inhibit the significant development. While this system moves west-northwestward over the next couple of days, regardless of development, the system could produce locally heavy rainfall across portions of the central and northern Lesser Antilles today, the Virgin Islands and Puerto Rico Thursday, tomorrow, and Hispaniola by Friday. Now, I've watched this over the past several days. The chance did get up to 30%. Yesterday it dropped down. It's down again this morning. 10 days of forming, 2 days and 5 days. So, guys in these areas, in the island areas and over in Puerto Rico, you're going to get rain. You might get a few gusty winds to blow up, but nothing that you cannot handle. Now we're going to check out the European model right quick. This is one. This morning we're going to check out European and GFS models. But you see, here's the system around 9 a.m. this morning right here. Winds in this system, the gusts are 35 knots. We'll put that down for you so you can know exactly how many miles per hour that will be. 40 mile per hour wind gusts. You guys can handle 40 mile per hour wind gusts, okay? You're going to get a lot of rain with it. We'll go over to the rain and thunder. You see the rain is nothing tightly compacted with so far as the cloud tops or anything else. Just rain, rain, rain. We will go back over to the wind. Sustained winds are not hardly anything at all. 28 miles per hour out of the southeast. But we will go back up to the wind gust. Now, as we let this track on through, you see the timestamp at the bottom. You guys are going to get rain. But see, this is going to push off and move north, northwestward. This is what it's looking like now, okay? This is set on the wind gust. You can see the winds are diminishing as it moves along and goes on over Puerto Rico. Now, it looks like it tries to reform a little bit, but then poof, by Friday, it is gone. Just completely, just about gone from everything. We'll stop this. You can see on Saturday, all broken up, not a lot going on, but we still have a chance of some rain in places from it, as you can see, as it travels across these areas here. Now, I mentioned another system. Now, by Tuesday, this coming Tuesday, the 20th, you can see right here, this is just a little area of disturbed weather, okay? That's what this is going on right here. And it is bringing with it a little bit of gusty winds and rain. You can barely see it make up, but let's move up to Wednesday. Then you can see it's trying to get a little better organized right in this area here. Now, we got a great big high up here, folks, okay? But this is riding the ridge of a low right here. And I don't think it'll turn into a tropical storm, but we never know. We never know. That's why I'm telling you right now. We'll keep our eyes on this, but the next one that I show you, it looks like it really is going to form. Who knows? It may even be a hurricane before it's over. But let's get back to this one right here. Not showing up yet from the National Hurricane Center, but it will be probably by the mid portion of next week. We'll go up to Thursday. Now you can see here it is right here, and it does have some pretty good wind gust with it. 48 mile per hour wind gust. We'll go to, this is midnight Thursday, let's go to Thursday afternoon at 5 p.m. Now you can see it trying to still push up, okay? Where it will go, nobody knows. We do have this wind field in it that has winds of 52 mile per hour wind gust. That's not sustained winds, but let's go on through to Friday the 23rd. We can see now this low is right off of the coast of Florida, almost to the coast of North Carolina, where the center of circulation will be. The winds coming down from the north. What about rain with this system as it moves through? You can see ahead of it, with the system coming down, we're going to have some rain, probably some severe rain from North Carolina and Virginia. So go ahead and prepare for that. We'll just have to watch this to see what materializes with it. Some of you may say, oh, the water's cooling up. It's not going to be warm enough to form anything. Well, you're wrong. Look at this, okay? Just look at this. Water temperatures do not start to cool any at all until you get up to Virginia Beach, moving northward and off the coast of Delaware, New Jersey, up in these areas. Water temp right down in here, 83 degrees. That's why I'm bringing this to your attention. It still could form. It may. I'm not saying it's going to. It may not. We need to watch it. Now, by early next Wednesday morning, 1 week from today, around 2 a.m., you can see we do have this low pressure that is coming up. Remember I said right off in this area? Here it is right here. We're going to go to Wednesday afternoon around 5 p.m. A little bit of wind field down here around Jamaica. Not bad, not bad at all. As you can see right here, the winds are only 29 miles per hour. That's the wind gust. The wind gust. But as we move through time next week, this is 5 a.m. Thursday, you can see it begins to get a little better vorticity rotation here, and the wind begins to pick up just a little more. We'll go to Friday morning around midnight. It is beginning to get stronger and stronger, and we'll push on off to Friday night, next Friday night, not this coming Friday night, next Friday night, the 23rd, around 9 p.m., and you can see everything is getting together. The wind 71 mile per hour, wind gust in some places, more than that in others probably. Let's check here, 67. So this could turn in, I have a feeling, if this forms, it could be epsilon. Maybe the other one will form. It would be epsilon. I do not know. It's too early to tell, but this looks like it has a good chance of forming. Now, you can see how it's pushing up northward, moving over Cuba, the Bahamas. What we have up here to look at right quick is what might be steering it. We got a high pressure to the left of it over here, which is going to keep it pushed up this way. We have a high pressure to the north of it. That's going to kind of keep it in the central location also. Now, when we come out to the west of it, what do we have? We have more little high pressures with one low that's way up here, and it's going to influence us too. It's just a matter of if this pushes up and over this way before this low gets offshore and pulls it on out. So, we need to be aware. We need to stay safe. That's your tropical update for today. Everyone stay safe. Boy, oh boy, I'll be glad when hurricane season's over with this year. What a mess we have had. Keep everybody in your thoughts and prayers that's been going through all this stuff, especially down in Louisiana, portions of Mississippi and Alabama, Florida Panhandle, the eastern sections of Texas. All you guys have really got hit more than you deserve. Nobody deserves a tropical storm or a hurricane. Please remember these folks, okay? And it's looking like it's not over yet for many people. So, with all that said and done, have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. I will keep watching these systems. Do not worry if anything comes of this. I will be sure and let you know. But everybody, do not get rid of your hurricane kits. Do not get rid of your hurricane plans. Hurricane season's not over yet. I love you guys. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe if you hadn't. Click that bell and check off all. Give me a like. I'd appreciate it a lot. Peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you. And thank you so much for watching.